Good morning, everyone. I think we'll start our program this morning. Welcome to North Glen's fourth annual Business Appreciation Breakfast. On behalf of the City Council and the North Glen team, we are thrilled to have so many companies attending today's event, especially at this hour and also the rain that came. So, you know, very unexpected, but kind of fits the theme for today, I think. We hope you enjoyed a peek at North Glen's history on the previous slideshow. North Glen has come a very long way since those early days, and we are proud of our history and continue to work towards building a great future for our residents, our businesses, and our visitors. Today's theme is Look to the Future, playing off the theme of Back to the Future movies. For the movie fans in the audience, you will know that Doc and Marty visited the future on October 21st, 2015. What a coincidence. Isn't this amazing? I know. And today, what is today? October 21st, 2015. Not only do we have an incredible keynote speaker who will be sharing her personal experiences of starting a business and growing it into a multi-million dollar company, but we also showcase and thank our successful and committed North Glen businesses. Also, you won't want to miss your photo opportunity after the event with the DeLorean, Doc, and Marty in the back of the room after the breakfast. So back there, you really need to do that. Like your business, the city is always looking into the future. And we are committed to creating a positive business climate to help you grow and succeed. Because if you are successful, North Glen is successful. This breakfast lets us recognize and personally thank our businesses for taking a risk and investing and creating jobs in our community. You are all making a positive difference in our city. North Glen is proud to have such a dynamic base of businesses that contribute to our robust economy. Our city is made up of more than 900 strong entrepreneurial businesses that employ thousands of people. Your business is essential to North Glen, and through your efforts, you are helping our community thrive. The city has officially proclaimed October 18th through October 24th as North Glen Business Appreciation Week. Every business is important, and we thank all of you for your commitment and dedication to our city. We hope when you leave today that you will be inspired and motivated to look to the future and growing your business in North Glen. Let's give all our North Glen businesses a big round of applause. Thank you. Before we start the program, I'd like to first recognize all of our elected officials. Please stand and remain standing as I read your names. Adams County Commissioners Eric Hansen, Chaz Tedesco, Jan Pawlowski, North Glen City Council members, Mayor Pro Tem Carol Dodge, Wayne Dodge, Leslie Carrico, Joe Brown, Marcy Whitman, Kyle Mullica, Kim Snetzinger, Gene Wynicke. I think that's all I've seen this morning. Yep, okay. Next, we have Hannah Mullen from Congressman Ed Perlmutter's office. And also, we have a special family here. Mr. and Mrs. North Glen is here. Iola and Bill Bean, would you please stand? Did I miss anyone? I hope I didn't, but if I did, please stand up and wave. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you for coming and sharing this year's business appreciation. Before we introduce our MC and speaker, we want to take a moment to thank our event sponsors and breakfast partners. They're located on the screen up here. Please join me in thanking them for their support. Also, you might be wondering why so many young people have joined us today. We all know that these young adults will be our future workforce and will be a major part in building our future. So we are excited to be partnering with North Glen High School's Science, Technology, Engineering, and Math, or the STEM school, which is much easier, students and teachers for the third year as part of our event. They're tremendous. The city challenged the North Glen High School STEM Engineering Design and Development capstone students to come up with a design concept for the table centerpieces. These 16 engineering students came up with six team ideas that represented the theme to look to the future. I am told that because of all the students did a fantastic job, that it was a very difficult decision. However, the centerpiece you see on your table was selected based on practical factors such as budget, size, usability, demonstrated the theme, and the ability to mass produce. This project is part of the student's senior capstone project. Also here today are five biomedical innovation students, which have been designing emergency rooms, which will be displayed in the back with the other students' projects. After the breakfast, we encourage you to visit with these amazing students. We would like to ask Carrie Glenn and Mike Sinja and the students to please stand and be recognized for their incredible work for these amazing projects. Please stand. There they are, back there. Now we will move into our program. We are pleased to introduce and welcome Jackie Palazzi as the MC for this event. Jackie has a very impressive 25-year broadcasting career as a writer, host, and producer. She won prestigious Emmy Awards for her work on a local news magazine show and was nominated three more times. She was the news director and anchor for the Aurora Channel 8 for 12 years, and you can now see Jackie on 9 News as a fill-in host on Colorado & Company. She has been a spokesman for local and national companies and has even appeared in several movies. Jackie is a mom of twin boys. I just heard they're 11 years old and very active. And has taken pride in her current role as a spokesman and family safety advocate for an Atlanta law firm, where she produces injury prevention and family safety segments. Jackie is a fifth-generation Colorado native. You will also recognize Jackie's voice on today's business videos. Please help me welcome Jackie to North Glen.
A little taller than the mayor, just a little. It's such an honor for me to be here. I came all the way from Parker, and again, it's my pleasure to be here. And what a great morning to be able to recognize so many really wonderful North Glen businesses. I'm sure as we look to the future looks very bright for North Glen, these businesses that are here today and businesses that are yet to come. And as I look to the future, I hope to look just like this in 20 years, so. Let's hope we all have that. So before we get started with today's award presentations, I have the great honor of introducing our keynote speaker, Julie Clark. I myself am very excited to hear her story, and she will be sharing her personal entrepreneurial journey and experiences with us all. But I'm first going to give you a little snapshot of her bio. I need my glasses for this. So Julie is known for founding the Baby Einstein Company, a startup business that was born in her basement and became an internationally acclaimed multi-million dollar company in less than 5 years. If you have children, nieces, nephews, or even grandchildren, you are certainly familiar with the Baby Einstein shows and products. Julie created an entirely new industry where she brought the arts to babies and toddlers in child-friendly ways that exposed an entire generation to classical music, art, and poetry. Her Baby Einstein videos and books have been translated into more than 30 languages. Isn't that unbelievable? And she has been on the New York Times bestseller list since the company's start over 15 years ago. Julie's extensive television appearances and feature articles are very impressive. Everything from the Oprah Show to the Today Show, to articles in the New York Times and even People Magazine. In 2009, Julie was personally honored at the President's State of the Union Address for her entrepreneurialism and business commitment. What an honor. She is also the founder of The Safe Side, a company dedicated to keeping children safe and to giving back to the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children. Most recently, Julie became involved in Soft Skin Company, a local startup which creates all-natural products for pregnant women, and her newest endeavor, Joybox, a unique technology company launching in 2016 for parents and their young children. We look forward to that. We are honored to have Julie here today to share her many entrepreneurialism, her journey and her experiences with us. So please welcome her with a round of applause.
Okay, so hopefully my technology works. It's always the tricky part. Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for inviting me here today to speak. It's always great to talk to people like me who are often entrepreneurs or startup businesses and people who are trying to figure things out and get it working and go with the flow and try to figure out what other people want as we start our businesses. So I like to call this "Hey, baby," because that's how I started. I started out as a mom, and I was actually a teacher. Before I was a mom, I taught high school English and art and decided to become a stay-at-home mom when my first daughter was born. So I'm here to talk to you today a little bit about my company, what I've done, and how I did it. And I've only got about a half an hour, so I'm going to do my best to keep you interested and entertained and fill you in with as much as I can in this short amount of time. So I want to start out by talking about inspiration, because if you've started a business or you have an idea, this is where it all comes from, right? We have to be inspired to do something. So inspiration is everywhere and often in unexpected places. You just have to keep your eyes open. And we have some young entrepreneurs in the audience today, which is fantastic. And so I want to start out by telling you the story of a couple of young entrepreneurs who were amazing and who did really cool things. And this is always inspirational to me because I think really young people can do stuff that is so cool and sometimes have a huge impact. So let me start out by telling you about a young man named Chester. Chester Greenfield was somebody you've probably never heard of, but I bet you've used a lot of his products. He was a little boy, and when he was about 15 years old, he loved to ice skate, lived in Maine. When he was about 15 years old, he was really frustrated because he loved to ice skate and go out in the winter, which is good because he lived in Maine. And he had an allergy, though, to wool, and so he could never wear a wool stocking cap. It would just drive him crazy. It would itch and itch and itch. So he went home to his grandma, and he came up with this really great idea, and ultimately ended up patenting this idea, and it was for earmuffs. So a 15-year-old young man came up with the idea for earmuffs. He had his grandma just sew these little things over his ears and put a band on top, and ultimately his product was used by the military. So the entire United States was using this product, and eventually the world. So World War I, World War II, his product was used all over the place. Pretty cool. Another young man who had an amazing invention that we still use today all over the world, Louis Braille. He was not born blind, but he did become blind as a result of an illness. And Louis came up with a system that we still use today. So again, another young person who came up with something that we use every day, or we don't necessarily unless we're blind, but that blind people use every single day. Really cool. Thirdly, another person, this person's actually still alive today, her name is Cassidy Goldstein, and though you've never probably heard her name, she's a young girl. When she was 12 years old, she came up with a really cool idea. She had an issue because her crayons were always broken, and she was going crazy. Her little brother was always breaking her crayons. So her mom came home one day, and her dad had given her mom a rose, and you know, when you get a single rose, sometimes they'll come in those little plastic containers that just hold one stem, and you can put a little water in that little container, stick the rose in there. She saw that, and she thought, wow, what a cool idea. I bet I could put a crayon in something like that, and it would prevent my crayon from breaking. So she did. Ultimately, she came up with a great idea, which are these crayon holders, which today she patented that idea. Today, those crayon holders are sold in Walmart. So just, again, another idea that was started from a very young mind and somebody who was inspired to make a change because she was looking for something that didn't exist in the market. And that's what we deal with a lot. So when you're an entrepreneur, a lot of times you'll hear people say, I'm an entrepreneur. The reason I became an entrepreneur is because I was trying to fill a need. I saw something that I want, or I wanted something, and I couldn't find it. And that's exactly what happened to me when I started the Baby Einstein Company. So I was a young mom. My daughter was a baby, and I was spending all my time with her because I was a stay-at-home mom. And I realized that there was something that she really loved to do, but I wasn't sure how to make this something that she could do on her own. So let me show you a little example. So hopefully my video is going to work here. Let's see. Hitting play, fingers crossed. Let's see if it works. Here we go. This is Aspen, my daughter, when she was about 6 months old, 5 months old. So I'm standing over her blowing bubbles. I'm playing classical music for her. She's very happy, as you can see. So the issue for me was that I couldn't stand there all day and blow bubbles and play classical music, because I actually had to do other things too. but she would have loved for me to do that. And I thought to myself, okay, I have a need. I have a little girl. I didn't want to expose her to stuff that I didn't love, because to me, this is the most important thing about little babies. Little babies are come to us as sort of these empty vessels, and we can fill those empty vessels with whatever we want. So we can fill it with junk, or we can fill them with really beautiful things. And I thought, well, okay, I didn't particularly want to fill her with Barney, because Barney made me crazy. Barney was a purple dinosaur whose voice made me want to blow my brains out. And so I had taught English and art, and I loved classical music, and I thought, okay, why has nobody ever thought to make a product that would expose kids to really beautiful things? They don't have to be exposed to Barney. They don't have to be exposed to junk. I could give my baby something really beautiful, and I think I could make it in a way that she really liked it. I knew what she liked looking at. I knew she liked laying on her back and watching bubbles come down on her face. I knew that she loved looking at the family cat. I knew that we would go to the mall, and if she saw a lava lamp, she'd be transfixed. And I thought, these are all pretty things. I mean, why not make a video of things like that, things that she likes to look at that are actually beautiful, that are part of her world, and set those things to classical music. And if my baby likes that, I bet you other babies would like that too. So I was, again, I had looked for something that didn't exist, and I was trying to find a way to make this work for my own baby, make something for my own baby. So this is how the idea for Baby Einstein came about. And so now I want to talk to you a little bit about what it is that you need to be sure of when you start a business. So these are all questions you ask yourself. So many of you, I mean, I know so many people who have ideas. They're like, oh my gosh, I thought of something. This would be so cool. Why can't, you know, I invent something like this? Why can't I make something like this? Why has nobody made something like this? So a few questions to ask yourself if you have an idea. The first question, or the first thing you want to make sure you're doing, is you want to make sure that you're being realistic, right? Is this something that I can actually do? Do I have an idea that's going to like change the world in a really remarkable way, in a way that I could do it? Or is this going to be something that's really difficult for me to do? So you have to be realistic. Is my goal something that I could actually achieve? I keep losing my connection here on my iPad. I'm sorry about this, guys. So, sorry, I'm just a little bit of technology here. Okay. All right, here we go. So being realistic. So first ask yourself this question. Can I really do this? Okay, can I really do this? Is this something that will work for me? For me it was. With Baby Einstein, it was pretty easy. I went into my basement and I shot videos of things that my baby girl liked to look at. These were, again, things like the family cat, or I put some stacking rings that my baby liked to play with up on a table, and I just took video of my hand doing those stacking rings. These were really simple images, and then again, set those to classical music. So it was something that I could do. It wasn't something that was too big for me. Another question you have to ask yourself is, can I afford to do this? I'm talking about time and I'm talking about money. And time is often the biggest challenge because when you start a business, it is so much work. It takes so much time to start a business. So you have to make sure that you can commit yourself because you don't want to invest the money unless you have the time because you don't want to waste any money. So make sure you have the time available to start a business. Make sure you have the money available to you. Another great question that you want to ask yourself. Will others want this? And can I accept the risk? So if it doesn't exist in the marketplace, for example, videos that expose babies to classical music and poetry and art, those didn't exist. So a question I had to ask myself is, why doesn't it exist? Does it not exist because other people don't want it? That could be. Or does it not exist because nobody else has come up with this idea? So sometimes what you want to do, if you have an idea like that, is actually go out and ask people you know. I didn't have focus groups with Baby Einstein. I didn't have any money for that. So I literally just asked friends of mine in playgroups, what do you think? Do you think your baby would like something like this? And just really did my research in my own little community, in my own little group. And so that's a great thing to do. Ask people, is this something that you would want for yourself? And if it is, if you're finding that other people would want this, can I accept the risk? So when I talk about risk, again, it's time, it's money, but there's also a lot of risk here. Because when you really work for something, when you try really, really hard to make something work, you're investing a lot of your heart. And if it fails, that's very, very difficult. So I would say be sure that you're prepared and that you understand that things don't always work out. So, and I've certainly been a victim of that myself. So Baby Einstein was wildly successful. I've had a couple of other businesses since that time that have not achieved the same kind of success. So I get it both ways. Okay, so another thing. Now you've come to this point, you've asked yourself these questions, you know what you want, you're gonna go ahead, you're gonna do it. And so now you need to surround yourself with people who believe in you and people who really believe that you can do this because you need cheerleaders, you need support. And for me, I was really lucky. I had a wonderful husband who was behind me. He was very entrepreneurial himself, and he believed I could do it, and I needed somebody like that. So I love this quote from Wayne Gretzky. He says, you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. And isn't that true? So that's just a little thing to inspire you to, hey, go ahead and do it. If you really have answered all those other questions and it looks like something that's possible for you and you really believe in it, you've got to try. Because if you don't try, you'll never succeed. So I'm going to use Baby Einstein as a case study and talk to you a little bit about what I did here. So Baby Einstein, let me talk to you about brand. Brand is so important, it's so critical. You need to have a great brand. You need to have, what I mean by that, a great name, a great motto, something that people want. They hear the name and that's like, wow, I want that. Or this is something that means something to me. So Baby Einstein did that perfectly because think about it. If you have a little baby, you go to the store. You're walking around the store. You've got your baby on your hip. And this is what happened. So people go into a store that's carrying the Baby Einstein product. They're walking around. They got their baby on their hip. They've never heard of the product before. But they look at the shelf, and they see a product called Baby Einstein. And they look at their baby. And they're like, well, yeah, of course. My baby is a Baby Einstein. So brand is so key. It's so important. So Baby Einstein was a great brand. And it's amazing to me, and I'm really proud to say, that I actually drew that logo at my kitchen table with my daughter's crayons the day that I thought of the idea for Baby Einstein and I came up with the name. I sat down at the table. I'm like, this would be kind of cool, and maybe I'll draw this little head and do this crazy Einstein hair. And it was just a terrific brand that worked. Another great example of a brand, just to give you a sense, is the Nike brand, right? So just do it. Think about that. Think about those words, just do it. I mean, that's what entrepreneurship is all about. This is what we want. We want to be people who do things. We want to be people who make changes. So Nike had it right. So a brand is more than a logo. It's an experience. So if you're coming up with an idea, you have a company that you're interested in starting, I would encourage you to think really strongly about your brand. It should say what you do. Don't make your name too long. Don't make your name so personal that it doesn't mean anything to the general community. You really want to think about your name, think about your brand. Another thing that entrepreneurs will tell you that they have a lot of is passion. So you, again, you have to believe in your idea. You have to really want to do it. When I started Baby Einstein, I honestly didn't even know I was starting a company. I named the very first video I made, I named it Baby Einstein. It wasn't even the name of a company. It was a video that I shot in my basement. But I really believed in it. So passion is when you put more energy into something that's required. And when you're passionate about something, you will do that because you care. And that's what it's about. To make your product succeed, to make your business succeed, you need to care and surround yourself with people who care. The next thing that was really important to me was targeting my market. So, very, very important. Target your market. Know who your customers are. For me, it was easy because I was my market. I was making a product for myself. I was a mom. I had a baby. I was making products for moms with babies. And so I thought to myself, okay, how can I do this? Who do I want to know about my product? And so I thought very carefully about the kind of stores that I wanted to carry my product. I thought very carefully about who I wanted to talk about my product. What were the proper PR sources for me? Who, for example, moms read Parenting Magazine, they read American Baby. So for me, I wanted my story to appear in those kinds of publications because those were the people who would be buying my product. At the time, it didn't matter so much to me if Business Week was carrying my product because a lot of young moms who weren't working didn't read Business Week. So think carefully about who your market is and really target your market. And I would tell you that the very most important thing that you want to do is be tenacious. And when I say that, what I mean is, of course, work your butt off. You really, when you believe, you're passionate about what you're doing, you're passionate about what you want, you're gonna work harder than you ever worked for anything before. And you might do things that are a little bit out of character. So I'm going to tell you a couple of stories about tenacity and how it worked for me. And I'm going to start out by taking you to New York City. So to backtrack for just a second, I came up with the idea for Baby Einstein. I made the first video. I shot it in my basement on borrowed video equipment. I had my product. It was a VHS tape because this was back in 1997. So it was on VHS. And I had it in a beautiful little package, and now what was I going to do? How was I going to get it into stores? And again, I thought about my market. I was targeting my market, and I knew the stores that I really wanted to carry my product were a group of stores called the Right Start. Now, if you've been to Cherry Creek, you may have seen a Right Start store. There is one in Cherry Creek. At the time that I started Baby Einstein, I didn't live in Colorado. I actually lived in Georgia for a little bit of time. And at that time, there was no Right Start store there, but they did have catalogs that went out all over the country. And that's where I shop for my baby. So I thought, okay, this is where I shop. I'm targeting my market. So I need my product to be in the Right Start catalog. How do I get it there? Well, I sent a copy of my VHS tape to the Right Start. They were based in California. And of course, I thought immediately they were going to call me because it was such a great idea. And I was very disturbed when they didn't, very sad when they didn't call me, and they didn't call, and they didn't call, and they didn't call. So I thought, okay, how can I get in front of these people? Well, I could go where they're going to be. I can go where their buyers are going to be. And I knew that their buyers, like all buyers in this industry, in this child industry, toys and videos and entertainment for little kids, they all go to Toy Fair. It's this huge trade show in New York City. About 20,000 people go to Toy Fair. This is a shot from up above, just looking down at a tiny little section of Toy Fair. And actually, when I first went to this trade show, I'd never been to a trade show before in my life. So I was walking into this show, no idea what to expect, no idea there were actually gonna be 20,000 people there, because here was my plan. My plan was, I have a great video. I'm gonna carry it around in my bag, and when I see a buyer from the Right Start, I'm gonna hand it to them, and they're gonna be really excited to see my video. Duh, that was not very realistic. So I go to this trade show, and I'm walking around, and I'm walking around, and again, 20,000 people. There's 300 people in this room, so imagine 20,000 people, and all I have is my video and my eyes that can look at people's name tags among 20,000 people and look for a name tag that says the right start. That was not easy. So 2 days, I'm walking around, looking at everybody's name tag, looking at everybody's name tag. And on the second day, I see a group of women and they're wearing Right Start name tags. And I am like beyond excited. I can't even believe it. So I race up to this group of women. I think I knocked over a few people on my way. I'm like, out of my way. So I find this group of women from the Right Start, and I am so excited and so passionate and so tenacious. I'm like, this is the best video for your store. You must buy it. You must buy it. It's so good. You're going to love it. It's perfect. I'm like, blah. So all I know in this like craziness is that I get my video into the hands of a buyer from the Right Start, and her name is Wendy, and that's all I know, because they're kind of like, yeah, fine lady, like we'll take your thing, don't hurt us. And so I get my video into their hands, and then they take off, and I take off and I leave. So a couple weeks go by, and I can't believe that they haven't called me and offered me like $10 million for my VHS tape, but they haven't. So now something comes into play that I know there are children in the audience, so I don't mean to give them a bad idea, but I do have to tell you that I had to tell a little fib. So sometimes you have to tell a little fib when you're tenacious and you're working really hard to get your video sold or your product sold. So here's what happened. A month has gone by since Toy Fair. I have not heard a word. So I call the Right Start. They're based in California, and I'm on the phone. And again, I have a VHS tape. I have not sold a single video. So I get on the phone, and I get the receptionist, and I say, hi, this is Julie Clark. I'm the president of the Baby Einstein Company. Like, it's like some big company. And can I please speak with Wendy? Because that's all I know, is I met a woman named Wendy at Toy Fair. I didn't even really meet her. I attacked her. So I get the receptionist, and she goes, well, Wendy doesn't work for us anymore. I'm like, oh, my God. So here's where the second fib comes in. So the second fib is, oh, my gosh, that's right. I totally remember now. Wendy told me she was leaving. Could you remind me? She told me who was replacing her, but I can't remember. And so the woman says, oh, yeah, definitely. That's Kathy. That would be Kathy Angel. She replaced Wendy. You might want to speak with her. I'm like, oh, yeah, Kathy. That's right. She told me Kathy was replacing her. Could I please speak with Kathy? So I get Kathy's voicemail. So now, line number three, my nose is like, ee. So now I get Kathy's voicemail. Hi, Kathy, this is Julie Clark. I'm the president of the Baby Einstein Company. And when I met with Wendy at Toy Fair, she absolutely loved my product. We had lunch. And it was great. And she was all about this new video that I've got. And she thought it would be perfect for the Right Start. And so she really wanted me to follow up by calling you and letting you know that you should have a copy of my video on your desk, but if you don't, I'd be happy to send you one because Wendy really, really wanted you to have this. So anyway, there's my little lie. I got a call back. So Kathy calls me. She says, hey, you know, yeah, I don't remember Wendy mentioning you, but I see your video on my desk. I'll take it home this weekend and check it out. She did. That little tiny lie was tiny. It didn't hurt anybody. That little tiny lie actually paid off a lot. So Kathy did try it out that weekend at home with her daughter. Her daughter loved it. She had a baby at home who loved the video. Thank you, baby, whatever your name is. Her baby loved it, and she said, you know what, we're going to try it. We're going to buy 100 videos. I was like, 100 videos? I couldn't believe it. I was so excited. So they did. They bought 100 videos, and you know what? That brand that I was telling you about, that great name, Baby Einstein, because of that name, those videos flew off of their shelves because of those mommies who all wanted their own little baby Einsteins. That video flew off their shelves. And when it did, buzz started. Because then the really important stuff happens, which is not only does the brand have a great name, it worked. So babies did love it. So that was fantastic. So The good news is what happened after that is Baby Einstein, the first video, did very well. The Right Start called. They said, can you make another video? I said, yes, of course. Made Baby Mozart, then Baby Bach, Baby Shakespeare, Baby Van Gogh. So for those of you who have never seen a Baby Einstein video, let me tell you, they were so much fun to make as a person who loves the arts. They were a blast to make. So for example, Baby Van Gogh, we had a little goat puppet who I named Vincent Van Goat, and he would introduce children to colors. So we were introducing babies to colors using things like beautiful artwork. We were introducing babies to words by using beautiful poetry by Shakespeare, but in fun ways that babies loved. So it was really neat. So ultimately, I ended up with a wonderful end cap in The Right Start. And this is just an example of some of the videos that we had. We also moved into books and toys and some other really terrific things. So it was fantastic. So that tenacity helped. You want to always make sure, too, that whenever you can, you're using reviews and media. So this is something that you can do on your own. For me, I didn't have a PR person. What I did have was a product that worked really well, so people did talk about it a lot, and that is actually what got me on Oprah, which was crazy. She wanted to do a story on women entrepreneurs. She had a producer who had a young child. He loved the Baby Einstein video. She said, oh, I think this lady started at home, and so that was how Oprah happened. But when you're just getting started, what you could do, and this is something I did with Baby Einstein early on, I submitted my product for review in magazines and publications. And of course, the world is very different now. Everybody looks at reviews because we can do that very easily on the internet. So I would encourage you, if you have a new idea or you have a new product, to submit it to as many places as possible to try to get people to review your product. It's just a wonderful way, if hopefully you get a good review. If your product's good, you will. It's just a great way to get some credibility and to get your product out into the marketplace. So, I want to talk to you about tenacity again, another really great little story here, something really terrific. I was living, as I said, in Georgia at the time, and CNN and Headline News, they were based in Atlanta. So here I was, this was before I sold any, before I even made that trip to New York City. I was sitting at home and I thought, well, I don't know, like Headline News is right down the road. I'm sure they want to do a story on Baby Einstein. Haven't sold a single copy yet. So I did it. I picked up the phone and I made a call. And this is sort of out of, this was like, just to kind of backtrack, this was out of character for me. I'm not really like a huge extrovert person, but it comes back to that idea of passion. When you care about it, you're passionate about it, you've made an investment of time, money, and heart, you do care. So you do things that are sometimes out of the box and sometimes unusual for you. So I make this phone call and I call CNN and I say, can I speak to somebody in your parenting department? Absolutely. I get in touch with this woman. Her name's Pat Etheridge. I say, hi, Pat. My name's Julie Clark. I'm the president of the Baby Einstein Company. And I have this really great product I'd like to tell you about. It's a video that helps to stimulate children and get them excited about the arts, get them excited about classical music and things that they might never have been exposed to before. It's really good for them. It stimulates their brains. And here's what Pat said. I mean, this is crazy. She said, wow, I'm doing a story right now on children and brain development and how children in Romanian orphanages do very poorly when they're not given attention and they're not given love and they're not given stimulation and they're not being read to and they're not hearing music and they're not doing all of these things that you're talking about. I actually am doing a story that's the opposite of that. And how cool would it be to do a story on your product too to show the difference in how you can raise a child. It was incredible. I was like, wow. And so this is where I have to say, you know, was that lucky? Absolutely. It was so lucky. I got Pat on that day. She was doing this story. But you know what? You make your own luck. Pat wasn't going to call me up if I hadn't called her. Nobody knew about Baby Einstein unless I was out there pushing it and talking about it. And so it was pretty terrific. So I'm going to show you another video clip. This is actually a piece from the story that ran on CNN.
Is this Mozart?
Volume up a little.
Julie Clark is putting into action.
I think baby likes to hear Mozart.
what most parents are just beginning to hear about. Exercises that enhance early child development.
The first 3 years of life is incredibly important. We know now that babies are really desperately in need of stimulation and love it.
The daily family routine involves a series of educational games.
An F, that's right.
That may actually spur critical connections in the brain of her 2-year-old daughter, Aspen.
3, 2, 1, faster!
As well as her baby on the way. Julie feels so strongly about the potential of early brain stimulation, she has produced and is now marketing a videotape for parents and their infants called Baby Einstein. Her motivation stems from a growing body of research that shows connections in the brain begin forming at a fast and furious rate even while the baby is still in the womb, and are crucial to the development of language, sight, and emotion. There's also evidence that playing or listening to music at an early age can lead to a better understanding of math later on. But as Julie Clark has discovered, parents have a myriad of early learning tools right at their fingertips.
What are those trees called?
Dogwood!
There are probably thousands and thousands of baby Einsteins out there just waiting to be stimulated in the right way. So as parents, I think any caring parent can have a bright child.
Pat Etheridge, CNN Atlanta.
It's hard to believe that little girl is 21 years old. So the really terrific thing is making that first video and coming up with that idea really allowed me to diversify. So I was able to move into things like music CDs, like books, and then broaden into other languages as well. So Baby Einstein books and videos in over 30 languages. It's pretty incredible. Sorry, keep losing my connection here. So in any case, diversification was fantastic. And it's something important to do. If you have a company, you have an idea, you build a brand, you build a business based on one item, you want to diversify, you want to grow your business so that you can stay fresh in people's minds. There we go. All right. Another really important thing, and I think Jack knows this, wherever Jack is sitting, our lemonade stand entrepreneur over here. It's really important to delegate and share. You didn't know how to build lemonade stands without your dad, I bet. So it's really, really important to make sure that you have people around you not only to support you as cheerleaders, but who can do the things that you can't do. So for me, I can barely multiply. It's really ridiculous, actually. I'm terrible at math. I needed a CFO. I needed somebody to handle the numbers and the books for me. You have to know your strengths and you have to know your weaknesses. Hire your weaknesses. So work with people who can do what you can't and appreciate them and value them for what they can do and recognize that we can't all do everything. So I surrounded myself with great people. Although I'll tell you, the really crazy thing is that by the time I sold Baby Einstein, 5 years after I started the company, I still only had 5 employees. It's pretty crazy, but I had 5 amazing employees. So I had 5 employees who could do the things that I couldn't do, and that was really critical. Steve Jobs has a great quote, and I love it. He says, "If you keep your eye on profit, you're going to skimp on product. But if you focus on making really great products, then the profits will follow." And that is so true. Don't make junk. And you know, the thing is, if you are doing this for the right reasons, if you're doing something because you're passionate about it, you're starting a business because you care about something, you likely won't skimp on product. I find that it's the people who are kind of the ones who copy other people who skimp on product. They try to make it cheaper. They try to make it faster. They don't invest the time. When you invest the time, you end up with products that work. And so now I want to show you a video of a kid that I just absolutely think is so terrific. His name is Ethan Bortnick. And when I talk about, you know, whether or not Baby Einstein works and why people talked about it, I can give you no better example than showing you this video.
Teacups or any of those?
No.
No, just a small one. Okay. So how did you get interested in the piano?
Well, I just had a little keyboard, and then I was playing, and then my parents didn't believe me.
What do you mean they didn't believe you? You mean they heard the sound coming out of the piano and didn't believe it was you?
They didn't believe it was me. So you know those Baby Einstein CDs?
Oh, the Baby Einstein CDs. Oh, yes, okay. So you were playing those.
So I was, I listened to every note, and then I just played it, and then they looked in the living room, and it was me.
Oh, okay. Well, I couldn't know. Wow. What else you got? Something else? What's the next one? Mozart?
Alaturka.
Love him. That kind of stuff, that kind of story, that kind of PR, that kind of exposure, that kind of you know, quality of product enabled Baby Einstein to grow like crazy. So in the first year that we started, we did about $100,000 in sales. And if you remember, I told you earlier I was a teacher. I don't know if there are any teachers in this audience, but I know there are students in this audience, and I can tell you, the teachers don't make enough money, so I definitely was not making $100,000 a year as a teacher. So that was pretty crazy. In the second year, we did $1 million in sales. In the third year, we did almost five million in sales, $4.5 million in sales. Fourth year, $12 million in sales. And in the fifth year, we did over $22 million in sales, and that was with 5 employees. And I worked from my basement. It was crazy, and I was making product that I loved. And I was making product that I believed in, and I was proud of. And it was a dream. It was really amazing. And every day I literally pinch myself and go, really? This happened to me? I can't believe it. So I have to tell you that 5 years in, as many of you know, I did sell the company. I had a really wonderful opportunity to sell the company to Disney. Let me go back. Yeah, oops, sorry, going backwards. I had a great opportunity to sell the company to Disney. I had worked with them, with Baby Einstein, on getting some of the books published, and so I had a great opportunity to meet the folks at Disney. And when we decided to make the sale, it was for this reason. Stephen Covey says it. He says, you have to decide what your highest priorities are and have the courage to say no to other things. And what happened is we had grown so exponentially. And now, as I said, we had 5 employees. I was working in my basement. I loved what I was doing. I was able to be a stay-at-home mom while I was working, which was really critical and important to me. And I realized that if I wanted to continue to grow the business, I was at a point where it was going to have to change. I was going to have to hire more people. I was going to have to get an office. I was going to have to work a heck of a lot more hours than I was already working. And so my husband and I looked at each other and said, you know, we could do that. We could probably grow this company to be a $100 million company. Disney has since grown it to be a $500 million company. But you know what? We didn't want to give up our life for that. And so we chose to sell the company for a lot more money than we ever thought we would have in our whole life. Not as much money as we maybe could have had if we had hung on to it longer, but enough. We knew what was enough. And I think that that is a really important lesson that I've learned. And not everybody feels that way. I mean, I know many, many entrepreneurs who keep going and keep going, and they're very, very happy with that. I will tell you, It was the best decision I ever made. It enabled me to spend more time with my family and more time with my children. And like I said, now they're 18 and 21, so it's pretty crazy how things change. I had the great fortune as well to work with some pretty cool people. So after I sold Baby Einstein to Disney, I decided to make another product. This was not for profit. This was 100% a give back product. So I worked with John Walsh, who many of you know from America's Most Wanted and now another show that he's got. And we made a really tremendous product for children called The Safe Side. It's DVDs that help kids who are about ages 4 to 8 or 9 learn how to stay safe with people they don't know, with people they kind of know, and with people on the internet. And we've been able to give that product to schools all over the country to use with their students. And we've been able to raise over $250,000 for the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children. So it's a fantastic product, and it enabled me to give back, which was really cool. And now I am working on a new product called Joybox, because it turns out that entrepreneurship tends to be contagious. Or maybe not contagious, maybe just like a lifelong disease. So it's something that when you start something and you have success, you do tend to kind of get addicted to it. You get addicted to making and creating things that are new. And so what Joybox is a really cool way to bring some of the same things that we did with Baby Einstein to this, to mobile technology. So we are making apps for parents that help them understand how to support their child's development when their kids are age 0 to 3. So for example, an 8-month-old baby, 75% of babies when they're 8 months old are crawling, 25% are not. That's okay. Kids develop at different paces. But we know from the app, if you have it as a new parent, that your child turned 8 months old today. So we would send you a little alert. Hey, your baby's 8 months old today. Are they crawling yet? Click yes if they are. Click no if they're not. Hey, they're not? Here's some little tips you could do. Here's some ideas that would help to encourage your child to do these things in really fun ways. Along with what we're doing for parents in this technology way, we're also making great products for babies. We're making more videos that are a little bit different, but equally beautiful. We're making toys. We're working with a toy company called Melissa and Doug to provide toys in boxes, these boxes of joy, that basically arrive at your doorstep that enable you to play with your child in really developmentally appropriate ways. So here are some things that are critical for a 6-month-old to play with. Here are some toys. Here are some toys for a 2-year-old to play with that are really important. And here's some ways that you can use these toys that would encourage your child to learn colors or numbers or shapes. So Joybox is really cool. I'm really excited about it. It'll be launching probably around February of 2016, next year. So ultimately, my final note to you is whenever you can make a difference in the world, it's awesome. And it may be something teeny tiny that you do, and it may be something bigger. Either way, if you can make a positive difference, Rosa Parks said it great, memories of our lives, our works, and deeds will continue in others. And I think they will, and I think they do. And so I encourage all of you to make a difference. So thank you so much. Thanks. Thank you.
So how many people are thinking, how come I didn't think of that? Wait a minute, what do I have that at home that I can do, right? Isn't she incredible? And brings an incredible story of inspiration. Another round of applause. I just put mints in my mouth because I had that coffee. And I have a lot of talking to do. So we're going to get started with today's award presentation. But first, there's a couple logistical items that I need to mention. So first, because we have so many wonderful businesses to honor today and only a limited amount of time before we all have to go back to our jobs, we will be asking that the honorable mentioned business winners to stand and remain at their table to receive their awards presented by a council member and to be recognized by the audience. Second, all the winners within each category will come up to the stage and accept their awards presented by our mayor. And for all the honorable mentioned winners today, we ask that you stay for a few minutes following the program for some group pictures and also to pick up your award signs and banners before leaving, and then you can go back to work. So if you're wondering how each of these businesses were selected, each year a committee of people that work within the business community reviews the existing North Glen communities, or companies rather, and the winners are selected based on the award criteria that's listed on the screen here. So I understand that this is not an easy job, and I can't even imagine what that's like since there are so many remarkable businesses in North Glen, but somebody's got to do it. So today we will be honoring businesses within the award categories listed on the screen, as I mentioned, and the first six categories will have two honorable mentions and one winner award. The Young Entrepreneur, People's Choice, and Community Impact are individual award winners. All right, everybody got it? We ready to begin? All right, so our first businesses that will be honored are home-based businesses. The list of businesses that were nominated within this category are listed on the screen. Our first honorable mention award for the 2015 Home-Based Business of the Year goes to ABC Delivery. Since 2012, ABC Delivery has been providing delivery and courier services. They employ 2 full-time employees and 8 part-time employees. On behalf of the City, Council Member Gene Winicky will present the award. Please help us to thank and recognize Shannon Olson, President and owner of ABC Delivery. Shannon, come on up. Not come on up, but stand to be recognized. See, you heard me. Excellent. Our second honorable mention award for the 2015 home-based business goes to Wilco Tree Service. Wilco Tree Service is a third-generation family business providing both residential and commercial tree services. They have been in North Glen since October 2012 and employ 6 people. On behalf of the City, Council Member Winicky will present the award. Help thank and recognize Mike Wills, President and owner of Wilco Tree Service. Congratulations. And now our winner for the 2015 Home-Based Business.
The winner of the 2015 Home-Based Business of the Year Award is presented to Wine Rock Photography. This award honors one successful North Glen home-based business.
My company, Wine Rock Photography, is a commercial company. I specialize in architectural photography. I mean, most of those clients are interior designers, architects, builders, granite companies. I also have a sub-company where I kind of work with families and senior pictures and couples. I love the opportunity to be able to do that. I got into this business in my early 20s, and I actually traveled around the country for several years, and I had the opportunity to start kind of collecting images, photographing my entire experience, and I really liked the opportunity of mixing technology with photography, and so I just started photographing as I traveled, and then I went to school. I have been in business since 2005, starting shooting the wedding stuff, and then 2006, 7-ish, I switched over to the commercial side of things. And I've been in North Glen for about 6 years. I teach at Red Rocks Community College in Lakewood. I teach photography classes, both introductory as well as more advanced classes. And then one of my favorite classes to teach is business. I do a couple classes over at the City of North Glen, teaching some of the people that work at the city social media, how to better use Twitter, Instagram, Facebook effectively. So some of my biggest successes, first and foremost, is staying in business since 2005. It amazes me every single day. Some of the clients that I've worked with or had the opportunity to work with is magazines like 5280. I'm the staff photographer for Boulder County Home and Garden. Shooting for companies like GE and McDonald's are some of the few companies I've photographed. I would see my company in about 3 to 5 years where I had the opportunity to have 2 employees. Up until now, I've only had 1, and I'd like to see my company have 2 to 3 employees so that I can actually manage my company and allow them to get out there and start shooting instead of me all the time. Doing business in North Glen has been a great opportunity. First and foremost, it's a great location. It gets me where I need really quickly. I don't do a lot of clients in the City of North Glen, but the City of North Glen itself, if I have any business questions, is really easy to contact, and they're always available for me, which has been great. Being the winner of the home-based business has meant a lot to me. I always get into my ruts about what my business is doing wrong because I'm always trying to make it better. And it was certainly an opportunity for me to be able to see that I'm doing some things right and people notice it, and it gets me excited for business all over again. I think what has inspired me most is the dedication that my family's had for me, that I've had the opportunity to dedicate all this time, which takes away from my wife and my kids, and for them being able to back me and just stand by my side, even when I'm working long hours and I'm away from home a lot. and they've stuck by me the entire time, and that alone inspires me. And the next challenge that I've had is the home-based business, at least for me, can get kind of lonely. And so really trying to find this opportunity to meet other photographers, network with other companies and businesses has been probably my biggest challenge, is to make sure that I'm not just sitting behind a desk and working on my images, but actually getting out there and participating in other people's lives and other businesses' lives.
All right, on behalf of the city, let's thank and welcome and recognize Paul Weinrock from Weinrock Photography. I'm glad you could get out, Paul. I know it gets lonely. All right, our next award will honor rookie businesses, acknowledging businesses open for 2 years or less. The list of businesses that were nominated within this category are on the screen. Our first honorable mention award for the 2015 Rookie Business of the Year goes to 5280 Creations Lab Specialists. Even though the owners are not rookies in the industry, they started 5280 Creations Lab Specialists in Northglen in October 2013 and employ three people. They are specialty dental lab and fabricates ceramics, crowns, bridges, and implants for the dental industry. On behalf of the city, Councilmember Marcy Whitman will present the award. Please help us thank and recognize Cindy and Kevin Kelly, owners of 5280 Creations Lab Specialists. Our second honorable mention award for the 2015 Rookie Business of the Year goes to North End Sound. Like the previous winner, the owner is not a rookie in the industry, but started North End Sound in Northglen in October 2013. They employ three people and use a network of 15 to 20 other independent contractors for special events. They provide a full spectrum of staging, sound, lighting, production, music, staging, and event services. In fact, North End Sound is providing our services today for this event. Let's give them a big round of thanks. On behalf of the city, Councilmember Whitman will present the award. And once again, we'll give Philip Jorgens, Yanyen? Yes. Yanyen! All right, congratulations. Well, now to the winner of the 2015 Rookie Business of the Year Award.
The winner of the 2015 Rookie Business of the Year Award is presented to Denver Escape Room. This award honors one successful Northglen startup business that has been in business for 2 years or less.
Denver Escape Room opened November 15th of 2014. We opened up our second store in the Phoenix area in August of 2015. We're opening our third store in Southeast Phoenix in a couple weeks. And we also should be opening up our Bakersfield, California location in the next week or two. We started the business after we went on a family vacation to New York City. My daughter wanted to plan a day of things for us to do in the city. She looked on TripAdvisor for things to do, and an escape room was number 4 on the list. So she said she wanted to do that. Wasn't real thrilled with the thought. I mean, there's so much to do in New York City. Statue of Liberty, Empire State Building, Times Square, and an escape room is number 4. Needless to say, we went and absolutely loved the idea. At the time, there was none of these escape rooms in Denver, so we decided to open up an escape room. Before I started Denver Escape Room, I owned a company called Colorado Overstock, and I sold things on the internet, whether it was on my website, eBay, Amazon, Craigslist, or just garage sales. We were successful, and it was a blast to do for 9 years. But I saw this opportunity and I wanted to take it and capitalize on bringing a new genre of entertainment to the area. And it's worked out fabulously. I couldn't complain one bit. In 3 to 5 years, I see us having 10 to 15 locations across the United States, with some of those being games only and some of those having the corporate team building facilities like we have here at Denver Escape Room. The corporate team building aspect of this is what sets us apart from all the rest. And most escape rooms will say they have corporate team building, but it's really just team building by participation. And we take that to another level. There's an education piece to it that is so valuable to the corporate teams that have come through. Aside from our expansion to other locations, we've grown the business well enough that we started with myself and my business partner to we now have 11 employees on staff. We've been fortunate enough that Denver actually has 7 of these facilities within 20 miles of us. And while a lot of companies would say, oh my gosh, that's a lot of competition, we don't look at it. It's a cooperative effort. All of us are educating the public as to what an escape room is and what the entertainment value is for it. I love doing business in the city of North Glen. Most of our success is due to their support and helping spread the word about what it is we do, sending people our way, working with the chamber, working with local caterers, and it's just, it's been great. I don't think we would have had nearly the success if we were in a different city where we would have been another number.
Well, please help me congratulate Denver Escape Room and invite Brian Lasertosek to come up to the stage. Congratulations, Brian. Our next award category is for the 2015 Small Business of the Year. These are businesses with 10 employees or less. The list of businesses that were nominated within this category are listed on the screen. Our first honorable mention award for the 2015 Small Business of the Year goes to Second Time Sports. Second Time Sports has been located in North Glen since 2012 and employs 4 people. They sell, trade, and buy new and used sporting equipment. On behalf of the city, Councilmember Joe Brown will present the award. Please help us thank and recognize Chuck and Anita Adam, owners of Second Time Sports. Our second honorable mention award for the 2015 Small Business of the Year goes to Twin Small Engine Repair. Twin Small Engine has been in North Glen since 2007 and employs 4 people. They repair small engines like lawnmowers, weed eaters, rototillers, snowblowers, and chainsaws. On behalf of the City, Councilmember Joe Brown will present the award. Please help us thank and recognize Bruce and Brian Tharnish, is that correct? President and owners of Twin Small Engine Repair. Now our winner for the 2015 Small Business of the Year. Here we go.
The winner of the 2015 Small Business of the Year Award is presented to Charlie's Auto and Truck Sales. This award honors one successful North Glen business that has less than 10 employees.
We started Charlie's Autos in 1997 when my wife was pregnant with our second baby, and we put $2,000 into a Charlie's Auto account. And we never had to borrow from that time on. The business just flourished. Charlie's Autos has been in North Glen since 1999, and we specialize in supplying transportation for commercial use, businesses in the community, and private transportation. We tend to sell more Jeep products than anything. I think how Charlie's Autos differs from the other auto dealerships is there's no pressure, no suits and ties, no big black magic markers holding you up, penciling deals back and forth for hours. It's just real laid back, easygoing, honest atmosphere. And you know exactly what you're getting, and you don't have to spend the whole day getting it. I would say Charlie's Auto Sales' biggest successes come from the trust and the integrity that we show to our customers. We have 3 generations of families coming in buying their vehicles here. Just last month we had a guy buy a vehicle, and he remembered coming here in a stroller with his parents, and now he's here buying his first car from us. It's a real honor to be able to celebrate 3 generations of families buying their families' cars here. I've loved doing business in the city of North Glen for almost 2 decades now because the community is a wonderful community. The police really have control. We have very little incident at our dealership, so we really appreciate that. And it's a lot of fun. I go around the community and I get recognized in 7-Eleven, Safeway, King Supers. Hey, you're Charlie. I bought a car from you 10 years ago. Or it's a lot of fun being known around the community and being able to share with everybody. One thing I can tell you about Charlie's Auto Sales is I was blessed with mentors early on in my life that taught us integrity and how to deal with people and give back to the community. And I think that has shaped our business form since the beginning. Being a used car dealer, I find it amazing There's so many businesses to choose from, and used car dealers don't always get the best reputation. So it's an honor to have our used car dealership be the business that's chosen. One of the funner things at Charlie's Autos is when you buy a car, you often get a drum solo after your purchase.
Nicely done. Let's congratulate Charlie and Terry Emka of Charlie's Auto and Truck Sales. Come on up to the stage to get your award from our mayor. All right, our next award category is for the 2015 Mid-Size Business of the Year. These are businesses with 11 to 25 employees, and the list of businesses that were not nominated within this category are on the screen. Our first honorable mention award for the 2015 Mid-Size Business of the Year goes to NationSearch.com. NationSearch.com specializes in professional background screening and employment recruitment services for companies nationwide. They opened in 2007 and employ 13 people. On behalf of the city, council member Kyle Mullica will present the award. Please help us thank and recognize NationSearch.com. And that's Jody Sarami. Congratulations. Our second honorable mention award for the 2015 Mid-Size Business of the Year goes to Saigon Basil Vietnamese Restaurant. Saigon Basil is a full-service Vietnamese restaurant that includes more than 200 specialty dishes. They opened in North Glen in 2013 and employ 12 people. On behalf of the city, Council Member Mullica will present the award, and please help us thank Saigon Basil Vietnamese Restaurant. Will the folks from Saigon Basil please stand? Congratulations. Now to the winner of our 2015 Mid-Size Business of the Year Award.
The winner of the 2015 Mid-Size Business of the Year Award is presented to Brock & Company CPAs. This award honors one successful North Glen business that has between 11 and 25 employees.
Brock & Company, we're a CPA firm, and we work with small, closely held, and family businesses. And our typical client is someone who's outgrown their prior CPA firm, and they need a higher level of expertise from their CPA. I'm a third generation CPA. My father, uncle, and grandfather are all CPAs, and they had worked for a company called Coopers & Lybrand. At the time I was going to go to college, I was going to go into electronics engineering, and at the time they were laying off people, so I talked to my grandfather, and he said even in the Great Depression, CPAs still had lots of work, so I decided to go into accounting. And I've been doing this now for 38 years. I've been in North Glen my whole life. I actually went to North Glen High School and graduated in 1972. Across the street from our office on Grant Street and 120th here at that, it was an old farm that had a 3-acre apple orchard, and that's where I went to Cub Scouts. Brock & Company has been at the North Glen location since 1990. However, prior to Brock & Company, we were known as Ernest Hewer & Company CPAs. It was founded by my father in Broomfield in 1958, and we moved to North Glen in 1990. And then 14 years ago, in 2001, Ernest Hewer & Company merged with Brock & Company CPAs. Our clients tend to be wealthy individuals, also closely held businesses, family businesses. We really don't try to go in and deal with SEC clients, publicly held companies. We also do not do work with municipalities like cities and school districts. We have a pretty good market niche in dealing with the small, closely held business. We continue to grow, and the way we grow is through client referrals. And I see us adding additional people to our North Glen office. It seems like our office has just been very successful in growing new clients. Also, our clients continue to evolve with their growth of their companies, and then we're also helping some of our clients selling their businesses or looking at possibly acquiring other businesses. We really enjoy doing business in North Glen, especially with the expansion across the street from our offices of all the restaurants. Our clients like it a lot. We also like the convenience. We are centrally located for our five offices. We have offices from Fort Collins down to Littleton. A lot of my clients are in South Denver or Boulder, Brighton, and they like the convenience of us being right at I-25 and 120th Avenue. The city of North Glen has been great to work with. They are truly interested in businesses and keeping and maintaining the businesses here in the community. Well, I think it's a great award, and it's just not for me. It's for our office, and we take a team approach. And I think it's for the team. Other office members and shareholders have worked with the city of North Glen. They've done presentations. We've reached out to the community and have been involved in the community. So I think it's a very nice honor to receive this award.
A great big congratulations to Brock & Company CPAs, and a welcome to Ken Huer. Please come up to the stage. Ken Huer is the principal and shareholder at Brock & Company CPAs. Congratulations. Our next award categories for the 2015 Large Business of the Year. These are businesses with more than 25 employees. The list of businesses that were nominated within this category are on the screen. Our first honorable mention award for the 2015 Large Business of the Year award goes to Mile High Thrift Store. Mile High Thrift Store moved to North Glen in 2011 and employs 115 people. The thrift store has an amazing selection of merchandise that changes daily. And so please help us thank and recognize. Unfortunately, they could not be here today, but a round of applause for them. Our second honorable mention award for the 2015 Large Business of the Year award goes to Walmart Neighborhood Market Pharmacy. Walmart built a new 41,000 square foot grocery and pharmacy in 2014 and employs 90 people. This major redevelopment project has transformed this area and added a new grocery to the city. On behalf of the city, Council Member Snetzinger will present the award. Please help us thank and recognize Walmart Neighborhood Market Pharmacy. Joe Ross, store manager, accept the new award today. Thank you so much. Now to our winner of the 2015 Large Business of the Year Award.
The winner of the 2015 Large Business of the Year Award is presented to Nexus Corporation. This award honors one successful North Glen business that has more than 25 employees.
Nexus Corporation started in 1967 in Denver. We moved to North Glen in 1982. We manufacture structures mainly for the greenhouse market. We sell all over the country, and we have distribution and salesmen that sell these products mainly in the greenhouse industry. Cheryl Longton and Mike Porter bought our company from the original owners in 1994. And they have grown the company from a smaller organization as we were then to a much larger worldwide type of corporation that we are. They've expanded in our different markets, and they've expanded with a lot of different salespeople in those markets. Right now, we're running about 35 employees here in North Glen. We ramp that up to maybe 45 during some other times of the year when we're busy here. The future is very green here. We have some opportunities all over the country, currently in Colorado, but the green industry is thriving. There's a lot of research going on with food products. There's a lot of opportunities with those research facilities, not only universities, but some of the companies that are trying to help with the food sources in our country and all over the world. One of the unique things that we do here at Nexus and how we got our start was through the engineering side of it. Greenhouses weren't a very engineered structure when we got started. The original owners were engineers, and they decided that they needed to be a more technical building. Previously, a lot of things were just bent round pipe, and we started welding our steel tubing together to make trusses. These structures became more elaborate, and they became more professional. It was something that the industry needed to mature and become, and the original owners saw that need and started the company to meet it.
We really feel very blessed that we have a great group of people that we work with every day. They've helped the company be very successful. Craig and I have both been with the company over 30 years. We have a couple employees been here over 40 years. We don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing, but once people come here, they tend to stay here and they don't leave. Nexus Corporation ships our product all over the United States. We ship into several different markets. We ship into the commercial flower market. We ship into the commercial vegetable markets. A lot of research facilities. In fact, we just completed a very nice project up at Colorado State University. Nexus has been in North Bend over 30 years, and we like to think that we're a pretty low maintenance company, but when we have needed help, and we expanded our operation several years ago, the city and the building departments and everybody were very good to work with. They helped us get the permits, and we've had a great relationship. Nexus Corporation, especially with Mike and Cheryl, are very involved in the community, very involved with charities. We've been involved with the Susan B. Coleman Foundation, as well as Been Blessed, the Urban Peak Projects. We've donated several greenhouses, one very recently to a food bank downtown that is just a great organization. One of the things that's important is to keep young people involved in our industry and in the greenhouse industry, and we support several scholarships and give those every year. Winning the Large Business Award in Northland is special. After being here for over 30 years, doing business this long and seeing some ups and downs and seeing a lot of neighbors come and go, and fortunately a lot more come and be successful now, it's very nice to be recognized as a Large Business of the Year.
Congratulations to Nexus Corporation. Please welcome managers Craig Humphreys and Craig Kaiser, managers, up to the stage. Our next award category is for Business Longevity of the Year. This award recognizes companies that have been located in North Glen for more than 20 years, and the list of businesses that were nominated are on the screen. Our first honorable mention award for business longevity goes to North Glen Heating and Air Conditioning. North Glen Heating and Air Conditioning has been in North Glen since 1960 and employs 17 people. They provide heating, cooling, and HVA services for both the residential and commercial markets. They were unable to join us today, but a round of applause for North Glen Heating and Air Conditioning. Our second honorable mention award for business longevity goes to Pioneer Sand Company. Pioneer Sand Company is the nation's largest landscaping material supplier. They have been in North Glen since 1991 and employ 10 people. They provide both commercial and individual sales of landscaping materials such as decorative rock, sand, stone, pond supplies, and other landscaping materials. On behalf of the city, Council Member Leslie Carrico will present the award, so please help us thank and recognize Pioneer Sand Company, and Susan Nathan from Commercial Sales will accept the award. Congratulations. All right, now to our winner for the 2015 Business Longevity of the Year Award.
The winner of the 2015 Business Longevity of the Year Award is presented to Horizons North Credit Union. This award honors one successful business that has been located in North Glen for more than 20 years.
The good thing about a credit union is everyone who's a member of a credit union is also an owner. And every owner gets one vote for their one share. So it doesn't matter if you're a 18-year-old who has $5 in the credit union, you still get one vote. And that's why we have a democratic structure and everybody shares in that. Horizons North Credit Union has been in North Glen for 55 years. We originally started with the Adams 12 School District employees in one of the offices at the district office, and they shared it with the spices that were used in the school lunch program. The school district has a great tie to North Glen, as we all know, so we've supported the employees. Decades back, we added the City of North Glen employees into our membership as well, so that even drew us ever tighter to the city itself. We recently added the entire Adams County into our membership as well. I would say over half of our members are relatives that our current members told about the credit union, and they came in and joined. We feel that's one of our best referral sources, is the family members. I think the City of North Glen, you can just see all the development that's going on in here, and down at 120th and Community Center, all that's going on there, the new hospital that's coming, is just like the rest of the county. Growth and new exciting businesses coming in, and we think we're going to be a part of that. Our plans are to have an electronic branch in the ESC for the school district. And from there, who knows, maybe we move a little further north in the county.
Well, Horizons North is very involved with our community and active with the city of Northland and Adams 12. We host a art show every year for Adams 12 five-star schools where we feature all the schools in the district and we ask them all to submit artwork. We also participate with Safe Street Halloween with the city of Northland. We also take part in Totes of Hope where every member of our staff actually volunteers with Adams 12 helping to pack food for students that may need it.
So we do a lot with the school district that our staff is very involved in and they do a great job. But we've also branched out not only to the city of North Glen where we sponsored many events, including Pirate Fest just recently, but also in the county. We've done many, many events. And that's just in our DNA that we give back to the community that supports us so well.
Horizons North Credit Union also has the Bright Horizons Award, which we give out once a month to a school in the Adams 12 five-star school district. It's given out randomly to one school that's entered by either a parent, a student, or someone involved with the district, just letting them know something good that a school has done. We want to feature all the good things that are going on with the school district. We go out and we give them lunch for the entire staff, we give them an award, and then we feature them on all our social media sites and on our website so everybody can just know all the amazing things that the schools are doing. We just want to let all of our members and also the people who are in our community know that we're here for them.
Well, congratulations to Horizons North Credit Union, and please welcome Brad Harvey, president of Horizons North, to come up to the stage. Also, members of the Horizons North Credit Union board have joined us today, so if you could please stand up to be recognized, that would be nice. So from here, we're going to move on to our landscaping awards. And for the second year, we will be recognizing and thanking businesses within the community that have maintained and improved their property landscaping. We've asked Sonia DiCarlo, chair of the Northern North Glen Planning Commission, to present the landscaping awards so our mayor could take a break. Let's see here. We're going to be moving on. Upgraded landscaping benefits not only the business, but the entire community. And it's contagious. Once a business upgrades, their neighbors are compelled to make improvements. It's sort of like keeping up with the Joneses. The North Glen Planning Commission has three landscaping categories they recognize businesses for, and those are listed on the screen. As with the other awards, the Honorable Mention Award winners will remain at their seat to be accepting of their awards, and the winners will come up to the stage. Thank you for joining us. So the first award category is for drought-resistant landscape, which recognizes the careful selection of plant material and landscape design that can thrive in Colorado's climate. The three companies are on the screen are honorable mentions within this category. So would representatives from the Glen Bar and Grill, the Vitamin Shop, and John King, manager from Larkburger, please stand to be recognized. Sometimes you feel like you're the only one in the room that everybody's looking at, right? You are. Congratulations. So we are honored to recognize the winner of the Commercial Drought Resistant Landscaping Award to TH Automotive. On behalf of the North Glen Planning Commission, we would like to honor and thank TH Automotive for their exceptional landscaping. TH Automotive was selected as the winner based on their attention to detail regarding plant selection and hardscaping, which creates a welcoming landscape year-round for customers and visitors to North Glen's Industrial Park. Accepting the award is Tim Hopp, owner of TH Automotive. Please come up to the stage, Tim. Congratulations. Appreciate you joining us today. Now get back to work.
Yes, I will.
Get that landscaping. Our next award is for the 2015 Commercial Properties for their aesthetic curb appeal, which recognizes the curb appeal and the attractiveness of the exterior of a business property when viewed from the street. The three commercial properties are on the screen, and they are honorable mention businesses within this category. So would representatives from O'Mara Ford, Aurora Valenzuela, Manager Starbucks, and Webster Lake Promenade please stand up to be recognized. Maybe they had to get back to work quickly. We are honored to recognize Office Plaza North as the winner of the commercial property for aesthetic curb appeal. Office Plaza North was selected as the winner based on their long-standing commitment to landscaping the Office Park grounds, which creates an attractive green space for employees and visitors. Would the Office Plaza North representative please come to the stage to accept your award? All right, moving on here, we are honored to recognize the Griff's Apartment as the winner of the Aesthetic Curb Appeal for Apartment Property Management, and I think it's Griffiths, rather. The Griffiths North Metro Apartments was selected as the winner based on their updated monument signature and signage, rather, and landscaping along Claude Court to create an inviting impression for residents and community members. Accepting the award is Celeste Rich from Griffiths Apartments. Please come to the stage to accept your 2015 Apartment Aesthetic Curb Appeal Landscaping Award. Congratulations. So one more round of applause for all the landscaping nominees and winners. Thank you for your efforts to beautify your property through landscaping improvements. It really makes a difference in the North Glen community. Congratulations. Okay, so we would like to invite the Mayor Pro Tem and board member of the North Glen Youth Commission, is that right? My paper is out of ink here. So to come up and present the Young Entrepreneur of the Year Award. Hi.
I'm Carol Dodge, by the way.
Hi, Carol. Carol Dodge, by the way. The 2015 Young Entrepreneur of the Year Awards. You will be amazed by the next winner and young entrepreneur that attends the North Glen STEM Magnet Lab School.
The winner of the 2015 Young Entrepreneurs Award is presented to Jack Bonneau with Jack Stands. This award honors one student that either lives in North Glen or attends a North Glen school K through 12. The student has demonstrated business entrepreneurism through innovation and vision.
My name is Jack Bonneau. I am 9 years old and I am a fifth grader at STEM Lab. I'm the founder and CEO of Jack Stands. I have 4 lemonade stands and I run one and I franchise my other 3 so other kids can sign up and run their own lemonade stand in a farmer's market in Erie, Lafayette, and Louisville. We will provide all the supplies and whoever runs it will get a portion of the profits. My dad gave me the idea of doing a lemonade stand because I wanted the Lego Death Star, which costed $400. I asked my dad if I could get it. He said, sure, but I'd have to pay for it. So I didn't know what I was gonna do, so he said, well, why don't you start a lemonade stand? So I did. I got my seed money from my dad for about $1,000. I also got a loan from Young Americans Bank for $5,000 so I could expand my business. I had 46 dates to fill when I first started Jack Stands, and I didn't know if I was gonna fill all of them. But if I didn't, I'd be serving a whole lot of lemonade myself. I charge $2.75 per cup for lemonade, iced tea, or an Arnold Palmer. They can pay with cash, credit card, or Bitcoin. In 3 to 5 years, I think my business will be me expanding my lemonade stands to about 13 farmers markets so more kids can have the opportunity to learn about financial literacy, business, entrepreneurship, gaining confidence, and making some money and having the fun at the same time. The advice that I would give to other kids who wanted to start their own business was make sure that the business is something that they really want to do and they'll stay committed to and have fun doing it.
This has been a fantastic experience for Jack. Jack has hosted over 100 kids through the summer through Jack Stands. So when a new parent and child comes to a Jack Stand, Jack will show them the ropes on how to set up the stand, set up the lemonade, and then Jack will have them count the initial bank, which is what they make change from. At the end of the day, Jack will have them count the ending bank to determine what their sales are. The kids do all their own math, and then Jack works through a mini P&L. He accommodates for expenses like sales tax, farmer's market fees, cost cost of the lemonade, cost of the iced tea, and then based on a sliding scale, Jack will have his own Jack Stands fees. If the family only sells less than 25 cups, then there are no Jack Stands fees because we want to make sure that the kids walk away with some money. If there are fees, then Jack charges an insurance fee, a Jack Stand fee of $10, and then a sliding scale, a percentage of the gross. Typically, they'll walk away with about $30 to $60 depending on how much they sell.
Being awarded the Young Entrepreneur Award of North Glen really means a lot to me. I've put a lot of effort into this. I just really am having a good time doing this, and knowing that I'm helping other kids while I'm doing that is just really awesome, and just having a great time.
Jack, I have good news for you today. You don't have to go back to school because you're coming home with me, because I have two 11-year-olds that need some advice and some of your tenacity, as Julie Clark was talking about. So on behalf of the city, we would like to honor and congratulate Jack Bonneau from Jack Stands. Jack's... Oh, just love Jack's story. His entrepreneurism, enthusiasm, innovation, vision, and success is invigorating, inspiring, correct? We can't wait to see what you're going to do in the future, and no doubt you are going to do wonderful things. So congratulations.
Thank you.
You're so welcome. Well, our next award category is for the 2015 People's Choice Award. This award is based on public vote from residents and members of the community for their favorite business. The criteria is based on businesses that provide they feel have the best customer service and product or service. There were too many businesses to list on the screen, so please see all of the nominated companies on the back of your program. So let's give them one all big hand of applause. One big applause. I think I've been talking too much. All right. And now for the 2015 People's Choice Award.
The winner of the 2015 People's Choice Award is presented to Denver Escape Room. This award honors one business that has been chosen through an online popular vote for having the best product or service and overall customer satisfaction.
This room is farewell. Your grandfather has passed away and you wanted to go back to his apartment, relive a few memories, and see if he left anything behind for you. So you called up the landlord to get permission. Of course you have permission. The only thing is that they're tearing the building down in an hour. So you have an hour to find whatever it is you're looking for. The Denver Escape Room is a fun, interactive, immersive puzzle room. We provide a scenario for you to come in with your friends, families, coworkers, and really use your brain. Things are not what they seem. You solve puzzles, find clues, use hints, and think outside the box to solve the ultimate goal, which changes and varies depending on which escape you go into. People haven't heard of this concept, and so they'll go to the website, and it's very vague and very general, and they still have questions. And that's all on purpose. All we're trying to do is intrigue you into coming to us. At the end of the day, you just need to know that it's a fun and entertaining activity for kids ranging from 7 all the way up to grandparents. Families and friends have a blast. It's a great date night thing. It's a fun thing to do just as a couple. And you may end up meeting a couple of other people doing the exact same room that you are. They're all gonna join you. Some of our fastest times of escaping the rooms have actually been by couples that are strangers that don't know each other. The number of people in each room varies from 2 to 6. Depends on the schedule, who signs up. But we hold up to 6 people per room. Powers of observation are huge, communication is huge. You just have to go in with an open mind and just start looking around, and things will kind of fall into place as the further you go along. Everybody has a blast. It really is something that anybody can do. When we first started, 99% of the people of the public had no clue what an escape room was. And now that we've gotten the word out, now that people have tried it, people talk about this for hours after they do it. And it intrigues their friends, their families, and they just keep spreading the word. The award is wonderful. It means to me that we've done a lot to help support the community, the city, and the chamber. By using local caterers, local businesses, wherever we could, it really does mean a lot to me and my staff that we've done something right.
So a show of hands, who's been to the Denver Escape Room? All right, a lot more to show up, right, Brian? So congratulations to our doubleheader, winning Rookie of the Year and the 2015 People's Choice. Welcome, Brian Lacertosa. Perfect time of year for that. Well, this last award category today is for the 2015 Business Community Impact of the Year. We hold this award to the very end because it recognizes not only a successful company in North Glen, but also acknowledges one business that has gone above and beyond to positively impact the community through philanthropic and community outreach efforts. The list of businesses that were nominated within this category are on the screen, so let's thank them all for going above and beyond. And now to the winner of our 2015 Community Impact Award.
The winner of the 2015 Community Impact Award is presented to Precision Metal Manufacturing. This award honors one business that has gone above and beyond to positively impact the community through philanthropic and/or outreach efforts.
Our company is Precision Metal Manufacturing. We are a job shop primarily. We serve customers that use metal, that have a need for precision. Most of our product is used in the medical, agricultural, aerospace, industrial, telecommunications, as well as other markets. We've been in North Glen since 2009, founded our company in 1997 in Denver. Having been there for 6 years, we chose to move to Arvada, stayed there for around 6 years, and now we're currently in this facility in North Glen. We found that North Glen was very receptive to our business and our needs, and was very helpful and instrumental in helping us whenever we would need it. I feel that our employees are extended family, and we try to treat our employees like family, and we feel that by doing that, they feel a part of the team, and we're able to satisfy our customers and our community with their involvement. The future for precision metal is bright. It's a growing industry. Manufacturing is a mainstay for this country. We employ quite a bit of automation. In the automation, we need skilled people that knows how to run the automation. North Glen has provided us with students that are very interested in our industry. We've given several tours to the local high schools that have a definite interest in manufacturing and the future of their community as well as America. Precision Metal is very proud to be in the North Glen community and very proud to be an employer. There's so many great people and people that are really caring and involved with the community and with the programs and the charity events that we're able to bring.
We have many different avenues of coming up with what charities we want to help and what events we want to host. We get a lot of input from the city of North Glen, checking out their webpage or their newsletter, seeing what events they have coming up. After we find a charity or an event we want to do, is we'll send out emails, see who wants to participate, who can help volunteer. We put posters and flyers up everywhere, whatever we can to help benefit each charity and each event that we host.
Precision Metal has done several drives in North Glen to help the community over the last few years. We've done a canned food drive, a bike drive, a coat drive, and all the employees really enjoy bringing in as many items as possible. It really helps with our community, and we love being involved in that.
Children's International, which we started in 1997, we've been able to benefit third world children. Everyone that's involved with our company is a part of this, and they can see how these kids have grown up and become young adults, and how we can continue to do that by sponsoring new children as we go. What this award means to Precision is that we become a entity that and a hub for the community, that we can sponsor these type of programs because we're fortunate enough to have grown and had this success to afford us the resources to be able to give back to the community. And our employees feel the same way. They feel that this is a good opportunity. Their response when we bring these programs up are very positive, and they're so willing to be involved.
We are honored to recognize the winner of the 2015 Community Impact Award, and that goes to Precision Metal Manufacturing and recognizing them for their philanthropic and community projects, including the North Glen Coat Drive, Food Drive, Bike Drive, and most recently, Safe Street Halloween programs. We would like to ask Precision Metal Manufacturing team, the entire team, to come up to the stage to be recognized. All right. Photo ops. Congratulations to Precision Metal Manufacturing. So before I turn the program over to the mayor, I'm impressed with all of the businesses here today, and it is truly an honor to be here to help recognize the businesses up north. I live down south, so impressive, and I will definitely be up here to visit some of the businesses that I've gotten to speak about today. So just 30 seconds of fun facts about Back to the Future. If you've all seen the movie, then you know some of the predictions that were made back in the day for 2015, and you know, so many of them have come true if you think about it. We think about 3D images, that was predicted and that's come true. Video conferencing is everywhere. Flat screen TVs are common in every household. Biometric fingerprints, we're using that even on our iPhones these days to log into our own phones. Holographic displays. Now, self-lacing tennis shoes, I think we're getting close. I think Nike has a prototype, but that was in the movie and not sure it's coming true quite yet, but that will be interesting to see. And of course, the Cubs win the World Series. I don't know about that one. But we'll see, they're in the running, right? So it wasn't too far off. So imagine what the future looks like. Thank you so much for allowing me to be a part of the present, and I really appreciate it. Thank you, and now for your mayor.
Thank you so much.
Now, I'm not as tall as Jackie, so here we go. Thank you so much, Jackie. You've been fabulous. We really appreciate all the work you did for emceeing and also the great facts, you know, for Back to the Future. Please, everyone, give Jackie an applause. She did great. Now, everyone, please take a moment to review the very impressive list in your program of more than 100 businesses that were nominated for these awards. Could we have all the businesses that were nominated or winners please stand and remain standing? Next, would all the North Glen businesses not already standing please stand? Please, let's give everyone a big round of applause. Thank you so much. I appreciate everything and congratulations to all the winners and the nominees. This is fabulous. This is what makes North Glen so great. It's all about you. So thank you very much. Before we leave, I'd like to invite Debbie Tuttle, North Glen's Economic Development Manager, to come up for a few closing comments and to briefly thank all the people that made this event possible. Debbie, would you please come up?
I'm not as short as a mayor.
What? Oh! Before I leave the stage, I want to thank Debbie for all the hard work she has done. Without Debbie, this would not be possible.
Oh, it's a team effort, believe me.
So there you go.
That's so nice. Thank you. Well, they always seem to surprise me. Well, did you guys have fun today? Yeah? Don't we have amazing North Glen companies? They just, they blow me away every time we do this every year. This is our fourth year doing this. I'm going to keep it really short. We're really over our time, and I can't tell you how much I appreciate you guys staying a little bit longer. So I'm going to keep this short. I know I'm in the way of the door prizes and also back there with the DeLorean and taking your pictures, so please make sure you do that. But I did want to thank a few people. First of all, Julie Clark had to leave. I want to tell you what happened to her today because you'll probably probably understand a little bit why she had to leave. So on the way, now remember how much it's raining, right? She lives clear out in Parker also, and her windshield wiper flew off on I-25, and she had to stop her car, pull it over, and she had to call her husband. Her husband came, and he has his slippers on. He refused to come in here, even though we invited him in. So she had to, so he was out there waiting for her so he could get back, get her back home so he could go to a meeting. So, but I really want to thank Julie. Wasn't she just truly amazing? Great stories. Also, Jackie, you're amazing. Jackie, stand up here. Come on. She was just amazing. She did all the voiceovers for the videos, and she did a fabulous job in highlighting our North Glen companies and keeping the program on track. But especially, you made the program fun. So thank you, Jackie. We really appreciate it today. Next, I'd like to thank the committee that assisted us with all of the committee award nominations. It's a difficult job, and they spent a lot of time doing that, so they were awesome. But I do want to thank all the sponsors on the screen. Without them, we could not have taken this breakfast to the next level. As you know, normally what we have done is done scripts. And Olivier, raise your hand, Olivier. Whoa. Olivier, First Light Video Productions did just an absolutely fabulous job of taking North Glen stories from paper and putting it into a real life company. Didn't he do a fabulous job? Thank you. North End Sound. When he was nominated for the Rookie of the Year, I kind of giggled because, of course, he is not a Rookie of the Year. I mean, this guy, he and his team do fabulous work. They do Red Rocks and big events. They do the Pirate Fest for us, our concerts, on, and the list goes on and on and on. New to North Glen, hasn't been here that long, but we're so pleased to have you here, and he has just been fantastic. All of these screens, all of the things here that you see today, we can attribute to him and his team. So thank you very much. We really appreciate it, Philip and your team. North Glen Urban Renewal Authority. Stand up for the people that are still here. I don't know how many we still have left here. The North Glen Urban, oh, a lot of them have left, I apologize. But they've sponsored this event every year now, and you've allowed us to take this breakfast to the next level through your sponsorship. So thank you very, very much. Again, we couldn't do it without all of you. Ramada Plaza, great venue, great food, big round of applause for them. Dodge Signs, he did all of the signs and the stickers. Many of you got stickers because you were nominees or winners that already came in the mail. For the people who were either honorable mentions or winners, you have large signs that you can display at your businesses, so please don't forget to pick those up. They'll be where the name tags were. And Dodge Signs did all of those. But most importantly, I can't believe he made the Doc, his team made that Doc and Marty thing back there. Take advantage of it. Go get your picture taken by the DeLorean. It's a great photo op. You'll see this. Also, Rocky Mountain DeLoreans Club brought the DeLorean. Great DeLorean. Where, do we have somebody from? Thank you very much. Artistic Flowers, Design, and Gifts. They brought the beautiful flowers again. Thank you so very much. They added that special elegance to our event. And to our North Glen High School STEM students, would all of them stand up? They did a fabulous job, didn't they? We love getting our kids involved. The last people that I want to really recognize are the people behind the scenes. I know the mayor gave me the flowers, but the flowers goes to our team because, honestly, I couldn't have done this without them. Susan Baca, are you in the room? She's probably still out. Where are you? Okay. John Eisel, stand up, please. Ryan Rakowski, Margo. I couldn't have done this without all of you guys. And a special kudo to John Eisel. This was his idea to hold the Back to the Future on the Back to Future Day. So thank you, John. I think it was a fun day. And again, we're here to help you. We've got things on your tables. Call us. We can help you. If you have questions, you're not sure where to go, feel free to give us a call. We want to help you be successful.